más locos del naipe, Las Vegas, 8 y media de la tarde. Para Mustafa Kani, todo va sobre ruedas en el difícil 5000 Six Max de las World Series of Poker. Un combo de buenas cartulinas y buenos faroles le han permitido triplicar el stack inicial. A falta de 3 horas para el final del día 1 y con 120 ciegas por delante, el objetivo está claro: seguir aporreando mientras se pueda, aplicar toda la presión del mundo e intentar terminar el día en lo más alto. A por ellos, amigo. Sin piedad.
Ace King from the button. I think I can 3-bet. It's an easy spot. Cut off against button, there is enough value to be taken. Also, my opponent is quite short stack, so I'm happy to broke preflop for this stack. So he calls. Ace, queen, queen. I can go both ways, but I think maybe a very small bet does the job. Very hard for him to fold the ace. Doesn't have so many queens. But also, like, his stack is quite shallow, so it's... I mean, it's not terrible. Check, check. Like, let's keep his bluff in. At the same time, you know, when he checks again river, I can value bet my ace king, quite happy. I mean, we are so shallow. I don't think I'm ever folding my hand. Okay, I have a decision here. I can raise him, but just call is fine. I don't think he pays me with much words. He stopped bet, he had only 10k behind. It's fine, I have better raises than ace king.
Coming old and tight, huh?
Why old and tight?
I'm not even sure you're a real Italian.
I'm the first Italian. I'm the first OG.
Nice.
Nobody would have been playing .com without me. I promise you that. I was the first one to move out, the first one to succeed. First Benzona. They needed a Moroccan to succeed in poker. Ay, ay, ay. I love these pocket aces from the cutoff. There is the gem of the short stack with 10k. Easy, easy call.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
Very nice, very nice. Throwing that on turn. Let's take these chips and pile it up. King queen off from the cutoff, easy open. Heads up against Santosh. I flop gutshot, flush draw to overcard. With this deepness I think I can easy bet and try to win it between turn and river. Even if I don't improve, but hopefully I improve. Turn is a deuce, not the best. I can go both ways here. I can bet, I can check. I bet around half pot. I like my bet. Your card. It's always nice to win small pots like this, and especially without showdown. Okay, everybody fold. We are small against big. Small blind call. I decide to check back ace 3. I like to do this kind of move, checking back some ace high to protect myself from the ace high board. Like otherwise the small blind can go just, you know, bet and would be really hard for me. So here he bet 1200 and I think I can easy call my hand. Ace high is still good often, I can improve, I have backdoor straight. I think I'm gonna check this hand. I don't see any benefits on the bet. I'm good enough times. Okay, king. King is spicy. I don't think he has so many tens that doesn't bet the turn. You know, if he has queen 10, king 10, jack 10, and also 10-3, 10-4, 10-5 will probably bet the turn. I don't think he's check calling. Maybe just hands like 9-10 he can be check calling. This is tricky. My hands is really bad, but I don't know, I don't believe he has so many tens here. I don't think he value bet a king. I don't think he bet any pair. Also, like, the king X can barrel often on the turn, because to make me fall like a deuce or something like this. And I think he's super polarized between bluff and value, and I don't see so much value, so I don't know, I call. Oh, he had the 7-5 for nothing. That was a good call. Just didn't make too much sense to me, the hands played by him.
Players and dealers in the 5K 6 max, complete this hand. You will be on a 20-minute break. Complete this hand, 20-minute break. We will be racing off the 100 value chips.
Can I have that 500 there?
In Vegas, it's always a good sign when you do the chip raise, because they always make it to the chip leader at the table. So if you're doing it, it means you're doing good. I believe it's our last break for the day.
Crazy mess.
What did I do?
Nah. Nothing bad. Playing good. Nice table too.
Yeah.
Now it got a bit worse, but
every time they bust someone in between us, they bring another one for you.
For us.
But I mean, you have the good, you have the right seat.
It's not true. You have more spots against Santos.
He's always trying to bluff me, this guy. But he's a good player.
Mangiare.
Let's double check they didn't make something wrong with the chip raise. But I think they got it right.
Players and dealers in the 5K No Limit 6 Max. Welcome back from your break. 1,000 small blind, 15 big blind, 15 big blind, Andy. 1-15-15, shuffle up a deal.
Oh, my favorite. I have aces on the small blind against Santos. I decide to 3x preflop. I don't see him folding much. He defends a lot, and you know, there is good value. He doesn't isolate enough to limp raise, so I think it's an easy raise. King 3 deuce is a very good flop for me. I think it's easy. I'm gonna bet the flop and bet the turn and the side. I go for a bit bigger sizing, because if he has a king, I don't see him folding. And okay, the 3 is really good for me. I mean, I hope he doesn't have a 3, but he's really good for me. I think I can bet here. Probably something around 13,000.
Super. The best super possible.
Got a new client. They just moved on seat one, a new player. Oh, I played against this guy. He really doesn't believe me.
Good for image. He's gonna pay.
Jack 8 suited. I raised the button to 3.5k. We are four way with one all in. And, me against the small blind and big blind.
Are you in it?
I mean, the side pot is quite big, so let's try to win it. So it's a very good flop for me, a flop two pair. I think I can only bet here. Can go for a big sizing. I bet 75, around 60% pot. And they both call. Often they have some flush draws, maybe some one of them has a top pair, even though I have a jack. Okay, turn is queen, that is quite bad. Often one of them has a 10 in their hand.
I haven't looked at the
flop. Jam. Oh, yeah.
How much is this?
I'm a bit tilted, but I have to let this one go. So often he has a 10. He can have like 10x of diamond. I don't see him really bluffing here without a 10 against two players.
Is there a 3 on the flop? On the turn?
I had two pairs. Yeah, he has king 10, the nuts.
Can't even jump. Top that anyway.
No, me two pair.
Two pair?
Good call.
Yeah.
Yeah. GG. Yeah, I played well.
Two pair on the flop.
There is not much to do. I mean, some people will call there with two pair, but I know the other guy, like, you know, I expect him to have something like that. We'll take our revenge later. I have 4 deuce suited from the bottom. I decide to open. They don't 3-bet enough. 35. At the same time, we play really deep, so I can win it often, I think. Especially heads up against the big blind, I like my chance. Flop is not the best for me. I can go both ways, have a small bet here or check back and try to wrap ace or king high between turn and river. Three of hearts on the turn is really good for me. It's one of the few cards that improve my equity some way. I have an open-ended now, and I don't think I can fold. Okay, river queen of hearts, that is actually a good card for me because I can wrap flushes now, and it doesn't seem like I have so many natural bluff on the river, so I have to bluff this one. There is not much I can do. I have four high on the river. I bet 13k and I take it down. It's so nice to win pots when you have the nut low. It's just one of the situations that you don't have so many natural bluffs, and you know, having a hand like that there on the river, you have to bluff. So another player, they are coming, we bust them and they're coming, always in the same seat too. Pocket tens. I decide to play it easy, just call and take it post flop. I don't know, sometimes I 3-bet, sometimes I just call, and I like to do it both. Quite good flop for me. I can do both ways, check raise or just check call. Now I have to bet, there is nothing else I can do. My hand needs value, needs protection. And I go for a big one. I go pot size bet. A bit over. Against him I like it. He's never folding, he's very sticky. This hand actually is like really, really good to take value. He has so many 8x, 9x that he is never folding. After checking back the flop, he quite told me like I have the best hands in some way. Okay, the river, I cannot do much. I don't really like it. I still think I have the best hand, but it's very hard to value bet here.
Excuse me.
Yeah, let's just check.
Green tea.
It's a bit unfortunate because like on a 4, a 3, a deuce, a 6, I had a really easy value bet. And I think on this river maybe it's better just to check call. Don't put yourself in a very hard spot, especially against him. With this spot I go over 210k stack. That is a really good stack for day one. This juice off from the bottom, it's easy open. And they both call. I think it's an easy check. I love to see that ace on the turn. No. I go for bet, bet. Bet turn, bet river. Almost any river.
Everything is cheap, kind of.
Yeah, but it's...
No, no, it's going up, but yeah, but I compared to London, so... What you spend in London, probably in Morocco, you have like four people working for you.
Pocket fives from the hijack. Oh, yeah, raise.
45.
I wish I had two.
So king queen six, not the best flop for me, but it's inter range against range. I just check back. He check. I think there is no point to bet here. I'm just gonna check again and bring this hand to showdown. Yeah, easy check check.
So lucky all the time, this guy. I'm joking.
Nice one, Andy.
Optimistic. You should feel like so good there with the six, no?
Yeah, I felt pretty good.
Yeah.
Might have, sir.
I thought about going bet, bet, bet flop. I'm retarded. Should have just fucking go bet, bet, bet.
Call, 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 easy.
Call, call, fold, bro. Call, fold, fold. Then, hi.
Pocket queens here. Very easy raise.
Yeah, see it open. 83.
45.
Eastern call from the cutoff. Okay. We are three way. Very nice flop for me. Quite dry, 7-3 deuce. A lot of value to be taken against the ranges if they don't flop a set. It's quite unfortunate. I decide to bet 5500. Quite standard.
55.
Turn is a 8. It doesn't change much. Only if he has like pocket 8s will change. I think he often has a pair to call cutoff like this. And there is still good value to be taken. Pot is 28. 28 and a half. I decide to bet 13.5. I plan to go all in on a lot of rivers for value. I have also the Queen of Hearts that helps. I block some flush draw combination. Okay, the king is quite tricky, but I still think, you know, he had more pocket pairs. He doesn't have many kings, only like King Jack of Hearts or King Ten of Hearts, and he's capable to fold it on the flop. Honestly, I think there is still value to take, and it seems a bit weird, but I think pocket queens still can go for a value jam here. Yeah, he snap calls. I hope he doesn't have sevens or eights. Okay. Hey, Mook. I take it. Very good value bet from me on the river there. It's not natural, but I think it's probably a mistake to check that river.
Thank you.
You thought it was pure. What did you think he has?
I'm gonna see it in 6 months, I'll let it don't pop.
No, not you.
Him? I don't know, it's or maybe one pair. Nines, tens, jacks.
Your fight is
canceled.
You wish. You got so excited.
You raise 25 up to 25, I call it.
I took 36.
Maybe.
Maybe I start to shake. I had the 10 of clubs. Pocket queens. Easy 3-bet against him. We played quite deep and I had a solid image against him all day, but I think
13.
Really easy for me to go for a 3-bet here with pocket queens. It's not really the situation where I'm super happy to get a 4-bet against him, but at the same time, it is what it is, I have queens. Ace 8-8 is not the best for me. I can go both ways, have a small bet and then check the turn or check back the flop. I decided to go for a small bet, makes the hand much easier, especially against a player that's capable to bluff me in between turn and river after goes, for example, check-check.
Players and dealers in the 5K open hold'em 6 max, complete this hand and deal 5 more hands.
Last 5 hands of the day. Hey. 10-9 of hearts, one of the last hands of the day, raise the button.
45.
The big blind defend. It's quite an aggressive player. He tries to make some moves. I played with him a few times. It's a quite nice board for me. I flopped the flush draw. Okay, he went a bit out of line by leading. I think I can go both ways, raise or call. Probably just calling is the safest. Maybe better to raise like ace high flush draws and stuff like this. So I'm just gonna play my equity. I'm in position, we play quite deep. Tarn is a really good card for me. Now I have two pair. And if he bets again, I'm gonna just call. And if he checks, I think I'm very happy to bet this hand, get some values from the straight draws, from worst two pairs, flush draws. I don't think I can do anything else but betting here. I just don't want to see a raise, but the times he calls, I'm very happy. Probably I'm gonna just check any river, except if I make a flush, but it's a very good bet to take on turn here. And I take the pot. Very good way to finish the day.
Dominate.
I had a queen and a three.
I saw a queen.
It's finished. Finally. Really good day from me. I'm very happy the way I played. Spot selection was good. Few bluffs I pick up were really good. So it's always nice to have days like this where everything goes your way. I coolered a few times, I made quads, aces to queens. Just a great day. Hopefully tomorrow I can do better.
Yeah, you need to put it in the bag too. Bright it. Another long day, huh? But and we play in the other room, huh?
Other room,
no? Other room in Bellis.
Yeah. Also.
Horseshoe, yeah.
Main.
Yeah.
See you tomorrow.
Yalla. Good night, huh?
Night.
Opa. It's been a long day. I'm so happy to go take a rest, have a few hours sleep and be ready for tomorrow. It's always so exciting to be on big day twos, and usually in these tournaments day two is the most important day, so I'm excited for tomorrow.
Hello.
Buah, no podía salir mejor, Mus. Nos has deleitado con un gran repertorio de todo lo que se te da bien en la mesa. Agresividad de killer, manos exprimidas al máximo, giro calls perfectos. ¡Bravo! Han pasado el corte 381 jugadores en este 5000 Six Max y estás muy arriba en la clasificación en duodécima posición con un stack de 312.500 puntos. ¡Enorme! Ahora a descansar, que te lo mereces. Nosotros volveremos muy pronto, ya en el día 2, en el próximo episodio de La Mente de un Pro.